that is adjectives and degrees of adjectives. Can anybody tell me what is an adjective? We have already studied in a lower class. So let us learn adjectives. Here, an adjective is a word that describes a noun or a pronoun. So it can be said the describing word. An adjective is a word which tells us the quality of a noun or a pronoun. So an adjective is a describing word which tells us more about a noun or a pronoun, children. So let us learn adjectives through examples here. So Mohan is a fat man. So how is Mohan? He is a fat man. Fat is an adjective because it is describing a noun, how he looks like. Okay, then the second example, the dress of this girl is yellow. So what color of the dress? It is. So it is yellow in color. So it is describing the girl's dress. So what color it is? So it's a yellow is an adjective here. Then the egg is in oval in shape. So how the egg looks like? Is it a round or in oval in shape? So the egg is oval in shape. What it is? It is describing the shape of a egg here. So it's oval in shape. So oval is a describing word. So the words like fat, yellow, oval, it describes the noun or a pronoun here. So let us do a small exercise. Let us do a small exercise, children, here. Let's circle the adjectives with red color in the following sentences. So we have to circle the adjectives in a red color. So let us take the first sentence. There are 7 colors in a rainbow. So how many colors are there in a rainbow? There are 7 colors. So 7 is an adjective here. It is telling more about the colors. Okay, children. So now let us take the second example. The mangoes are ripe and juicy. So how are the mangoes? They are raw. No. So they are ripe and juicy. So they are telling the mangoes are ripe and juicy. Okay? These are the adjectives. Ripe and juicy is an adjective. So it is describing more about a fruit, that is mango. Okay? Let us take the third example. Deepak bought a black bike. So Deepak bought a bike. So what color it is? It is black in color. So black is an adjective here. The fourth one is the bridge was narrow. How was the bridge? Was it broad or narrow? It was narrow. So narrow is an adjective. It is describing more about the bridge. Okay, children. Now fifth one. Roses are red in color. What color the roses are? Okay, so the roses are in red color. So red is an adjective here. Okay, children. So an adjective is a word that describes more about a noun or a pronoun. So it's called as a describing word also. Okay, children, and it tells the quality of a noun or a pronoun. Understood, children? You have learned about the adjectives, children. Now we'll learn about the degrees of adjectives. And there are 3 degrees of adjectives. What are they? They are positive degree, comparative degree, and superlative degree. Let us learn what is positive degree, children. An adjective is in the positive degree when it is used to state some quality as it is. It is used when no comparison is made. An adjective is in its base form is said to be in a positive form.
Let us take an example. He is a smart boy. Here, the boy is not compared with any other boys. We are speaking about a single boy, that the boy is smart.
Now we learn about the comparative degree. An adjective is in the comparative degree when the comparison is made between two nouns. Let us see the example here. He is smarter than Abhi. So here two boys are there. So a comparison is made between two boys. He is smarter than Abhi. Now let us learn about the superlative degree. An adjective is in the superlative degree when comparison is made among many nouns. So here in superlative, we compare with many nouns or pronouns. Let us take an example here. He is the smartest boy in his class. So in this example, this boy is compared with all the boys in the class, and he is the smartest among all the boys. You have learned about the positive degree, comparative degree and superlative degree. Let us learn through chart. Okay, here is a positive degree, comparative degree and superlative degree. Positive degree, we are not comparing with anybody. Then in comparative degree, we add the words like more or ear. Okay, and in superlative degree, we add the words like most or est. Okay, now let us see the examples here. Rich, richer, richest. Big, bigger, biggest. Good, better, best. Beautiful, more beautiful, most beautiful. Cheap, cheaper, cheapest. Okay children, and now we will do a small exercise just to understand better the degrees of adjectives. So, complete the following sentence with positive degree. Okay, let us take the first sentence. Ram is a dash boy. So, we are not comparing with any other noun or a pronoun. So, here it is top. Top. Okay, now we'll go to the second sentence. Kolkata is a dash city. So we are not comparing it positive. Okay, so it is big city. Big. Okay, children. And here, complete the following sentence with comparative degree. In comparative degree, we compare with two nouns or pronouns. Understood, children? Second sentence, Sita is dash then Mita. Sita is dash then Mita. Wise or wiser? Which one comes? We are comparing between two girls. So, when we compare, what we add? We add more or ear. Okay? So now, here is wiser. So Sita is wiser than Meeta. Understood, children? So complete the following sentence with superlative degree. So let us take the first example, children. That is, Sachin is the dash batsman of Indian team. So here in superlative degree, children, we are comparing with two or more nouns or pronouns. So good is the answer or the best is the answer. When we are comparing with more many nouns, it becomes the best. So Sachin is the best batsman of Indian team. So let us take the next sentence. That is, Mount Everest is the dash peak in the world. So we are comparing with many nouns here. So high is the correct answer or the highest is the correct answer, children? So highest is the correct answer. So Mount Everest is the highest peak in the world. So let us recap what we have learnt today in adjectives. So we have learnt about adjectives and we have learnt about degrees of adjectives. In degrees of adjectives, we have learnt positive degree, comparative degree and superlative degree. Positive degree, we don't compare. Okay? And in comparative degree, we compare with two nouns or pronouns. And in superlative degree, we compare with many nouns or pronouns. Okay, children? So, I hope you have understood this topic, that is adjectives and degrees of adjectives. So, I want you to do a homework, children. I want you to write 5 examples of the sentences of adjectives, then degrees of adjectives, that is positive degree, comparative degree and superlative degree. All 5 sentences you have to write it in a book. That is your homework. In the next class, I'll come up with another topic. Until then, have a great day. Have a good day. Goodbye.